Des Moines three times, and Kansas has been the top seed three times. So welcome back to Des Moines, Coach.
Well, we love coming here. Des Moines has been very good to us, and we know all the best places to eat. So it's been good.
This time we'll take questions. Please raise your hand. We have a microphone holder. Front row, left side.
Hey, Coach. Scott Reese, KCTV5. Two-part question. First, as a guy who's been around and doing this as long as you have, maybe just some perspective on how difficult it is to defend a national title.
Well, it is difficult, but you know, the tough thing is that when you're at Kansas, I shouldn't say the tough thing, the good thing is, when you're at Kansas, you're always getting everybody's best shot every single time you play. So it's just added on to us being national champions and those things. And we haven't really talked about that a ton. What we've talked about is staying in the moment and playing for now. This is a different team. What we accomplished last year was fantastic. We enjoy it. We're honored by it. But we also understand this is a whole new situation.
If you'll indulge me one more kind of big picture, how has it been so, I don't want to say seamless, but you lose 70% of your production from a national title team, and yet here you are, number one seed. That's not easy to do. How has this group been able to kind of pick up where you left off and make it look seamless?
Well, it's not seamless, but I would say, you know, our motto at our place is faces change, expectations don't. And our guys understand that. We know, and the one thing that we have is, you know, we have a great coach, and he utilizes his team in the best way, and he figures out a way that's going to be best for that particular group. We played a certain way last year that was very good for that team, and this year we had to tweak things and play a little bit differently, and Coach Self is never afraid to do anything like that, and our guys have really responded.
I'm going to stay on the left side. Go ahead.
Hey, Norm. David Lawrence, Jayhawk Radio. Just talk about finally getting out of the conference and playing someone else, and a rundown of Coach Blakeney's team. Obviously, they like to get out and run and shoot threes, and do they remind you of any conference team?
I don't know if they remind you of any conference team, but the one thing they are is they're very, very long. They're very long. They've got a lot of size on the perimeter, 6'9", settles, you know, so they're big. And we've had to deal with that all season. They have an unbelievable point guard in Hawkins who can really, he can shoot. He shoots 47% from the three, but he's an unbelievable quarterback, very similar to Juan. He gets the ball to the guys in the right position. Dockery is a tremendous shooter for them. Settles, you know, made second team all conference. Elijah, first team all conference. So you're playing against a champion. You're playing against a team that knows how to win. You're playing against a team that's older. And I'm battle tested, so we know we're going to get their best shot. And you know, Coach Blakeney has done a great job with that program, and they're playing really well right now.
Front row.
Gary Bedard, KC Star. Coach, what's the condition of Coach Self, and do you expect he'll coach tomorrow? And how is he today? And I have a follow up.
He's doing well today. He was at practice today. He was at practice last night in all of our meetings. He's doing well. He's getting better all the time. We're hopeful, and everything is day-to-day with him. But if you ask our guys, he got after him pretty good today. So he was doing really well.
And what about Grady Dick and Kevin McCullough's physical condition updates?
Oh, both guys practiced full speed today and had great bounce to them. So they're both doing well.
Stay on the left side on the aisle.
Nick Springer, Rock Chalk Sports Talk. Coach, how much do you think Big 12 conference play has helped prepare your team for making a deep tournament run this year?
Well, in the Big 12, you're going to play against all styles. You'll play against zone. You'll play against man. You'll play against physicality. You'll play against speed. You'll play against size. You know, so you're going to get the gamut of everything. So hopefully that has prepared us for the tournament. You know, it's one of those things that in our league, you know, it was a battle every single night, no matter where you were, home or away, and hopefully that'll help us in the tournament.
Question on the back corner, and then we'll move up there. Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, Eric Olson with the Associated Press. I just wanted to follow up on Coach Self. Was his absence today from the media stuff, is that just because he's just recuperating and tired, or could you just kind of talk about that?
Oh, he's getting his rest. He's getting his rest and that stuff. So maybe he thinks that I talk too much, so he's letting me talk more. So, but he's just back getting some rest right now. He's doing good, though.
Hi, Norm. Will Kennedy with the Des Moines Register. Joseph obviously played in Des Moines for a little bit, played at Drake. When, I don't want you to speak for Coach Self, but when he entered the transfer portal, what did you guys as a staff see in him to make him want to come to Kansas?
Well, we saw explosiveness, scoring ability. You know, obviously that dunk he had was the big show of the NCAA tournament that year. And Joe has done good for us. He has done good for us. He supplies a spark off the bench, both offensively and defensively.
Other questions? We have about 4 minutes left here. Left side, back row.
Dan Lucero, WIBW Topeka. Obviously, last year you guys went into the NCAA tournament on the high of having won the Big 12 tournament, used that momentum to win the national championship. This year you come in having lost in the Big 12 championship game. How can you use that, the lessons from that defeat, as a positive and kind of spin that as a positive way to go into the tournament, having learned lessons from loss in that way?
Well, you can do a lot by learning from sometimes failure or a lack of success. And you know, we realized there were some things that we did in those games, or in that game particularly, that we need to get better at. And we didn't defend. We didn't play. We had really played well defensively the first two games. And the last game, we did not come out with that mindset. And if you don't come out with that mindset against a good team and a talented team as Texas is, you're going to put yourself behind the eight ball. And we did. And then as the game went on, I thought we'd get a little fatigued. And then we made some ill-advised mistakes at the end of the shot clock, and they took advantage of it. So give them a lot of credit with what they did. But we've already been able to watch film, look at that, and say, hey, this is where we got to get better.
Any other questions out there for Coach Roberts? In the back row.
Brendan Dorzinski, WIBW Topeka. You mentioned Kevin's feeling better going into this week. How important is it specifically on the defensive end to get him back as soon as possible?
It's huge. It's huge. Well, you're talking about one of the best defensive players in the country in Kevin McCullers. I mean, he can guard a point guard or he can guard a center. Doesn't matter. And the other thing that Kevin does for us is he does so many little things as far as offensive rebounding, defensive rebounding. And then he's an extremely good cutter in our offense. So we missed him quite a bit in that game, but we knew he would be out because you got to go for the long haul and that stuff. But he was back today, and he was doing really well.